Right friends, welcome back to News at a Glance for 50th week. The first item is government approved the rollout of public finance management system, popularly known as PFMS. What is the purpose of PFMS? Basically, this is to look into two aspects, whether funds are released for central government programs well in time or not. The second one is complete monitoring of the usage of funds, and all of you are familiar with several flagship programs of central government. One is Mahatma Gandhi Narega, the second one here Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. So central government schemes are there, and to monitor these schemes effectively, this central government approved the rollout of public finance management system. And if you look at the second news item, Andhra Pradesh government launched AP Purse mobile application. Here, the application features 13 mobile banking and 10 mobile wallet options. And now, more and more state governments are launching these type of applications. Then, BRICS countries agreed to share tax information automatically. And here, this is as per automatic exchange of information. And two things I would like to reiterate. The first aspect is BEPS, base erosion and profit shifting. This is the mechanism the multinational companies are resorting to avoid the payment of taxes and to control that, what the Indian government has done. Indian government is reviewing protocols of double taxation avoidance agreements, and recently government modified protocols pertaining to Mauritius as well as Cyprus. And the second thing is automatic exchange of information. India signed multilateral competent authority agreement under the framework of multilateral competent authority agreement. India will receive automatic tax related information from the countries which are signatories to MCAA, and for ensuring the information is understandable by one and all, common reporting standards are evolved. So BEPS as well as AEOI, these two are into the news recently, and these two are piloted by OECD, Paris based organization. That is very important. And now this news item is pertaining to BRICS countries. BRICS countries agreed to share tax information automatically as per the commitment to ensure fairness of international tax system. Here, please look into this. These are five BRICS countries, and New Development Bank or BRICS Bank, Shanghai headquartered, headed by KV Kamath. This is a BRICS bank, BRICS promoted bank, these things don't forget. And Parliament passed Taxation Laws Second Amendment Bill 2016. And here, there are two aspects everyone should understand. One is, when the person declares undisclosed income voluntarily. And please don't forget, government's voluntary disclosure scheme, or you can say income declaration scheme, ended on 30th September. And you can say this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana is the last option given to the black money holders. Here, left side, please go through it. As per this Taxation Laws Second Amendment Bill, tax will be at 30%, penalty 10%, surcharge is 10%, or to be specific 9.9%, because it is 33% of tax. So total tax comes to around 50%. If someone asks you specifically, it is 49.9%, and then 25% of the undisclosed income will be locked up for 4 years, right? And after 4 years, people will get it without any interest. That is very important aspect. And straight away, directly at this juncture, by disclosing income, they can straight away take 25.1%. So if someone is declaring 100 rupees undisclosed income, 49.9 rupees goes to tax surcharge penalty, 25 rupees will be locked in for 4 years, 25.10 he can straight away take, right? This is all about when the person declares voluntarily and the scheme is Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. Then if the person is not declaring voluntarily and if the income tax authorities notice that it is undeclared cash and assets, then tax is 60%, then surcharge is 15%, then cess is 2.25%. So the total comes to 77.25% and additional penalty of 10% can be imposed. Right? So this is all about the taxation laws, the second amendment bill of 2016, which was passed by parliament. The government allowed Urgin Trinley Dorje. He is the 17th Karmapa. And I would like to tell you a few points. There are four schools of thought as far as Tibetan Buddhism is concerned. And this is the Kakyu school of thought. This is one type of four schools of thought. And recently, government granted permission for Gyalwang Karmapa to visit Arunachal Pradesh. If you want more details, please go through this slide. Then government gave clarification with regard to the passage of taxation laws, the second amendment bill 2016, with regard to the holding of gold jewelry and ornaments by the individual households. All of you are familiar with Indians' fascination for gold. And as per this taxation laws, second amendment bill 2016, during the search operations, if gold and jewelry to the extent of 500 grams for the married woman, 250 grams for unmarried girl, and 100 grams per male member is found, no one can question you. If the gold holding is more than that, you have to produce legitimacy of it. You have to produce the documents that you are legitimate owner for that. So, legitimate holding of jewelry up to any extent is fully protected, but up to 500 grams, 250 grams, 100 grams, no one can question you. So, that is as per this taxation laws amendment bill 2016, because government has to give clarification because there were a lot many misgivings about this. Then all of you are familiar with the Motera Stadium. Please look into this. This is Motera Cricket Stadium, which is also known as Sardar Patel Stadium. This is in Motera area of Ahmedabad, and L&T was given contract for renovation of the stadium. And once it is renovated, the seating capacity will go up to 1,10,000. At present, the seating capacity is just 54,000. Once it is renovated, it will go up to 1,10,000. That means once it is completed, it will become the world's largest cricket stadium as far as the seating capacity is concerned. And at present, Melbourne Cricket Ground in Australia has got capacity of around 1,00,000 seating capacity. Right? So once this is constructed, this Motera Stadium, or you can say Sardar Patel Stadium in Ahmedabad, will become the largest in terms of seating capacity in the world. Then this news item is with regard to Internet and Mobile Association of India. Recently, Internet and Mobile Association of India constituted Ajit Mohan Committee. You may ask, what is the need for this committee? Basically, to check the menace of online piracy. Online piracy is the basic problem in our country. So, to check the online piracy, and at the same time, to safeguard the interests of the digital entertainment businesses, This Ajit Mohan Committee was constituted by Internet and Mobile Association of India. Then Union Government has decided to introduce direct benefit transfer system fertilizers. Two, three important aspects I would like to tell you. Direct benefit transfer has already been introduced for LPG. People are getting directly into their bank accounts. And the second point is, recently central government introduced direct benefit transfer for kerosene on experimental basis in Jharkhand. This is very important. And now government is planning to implement this direct benefit transfer for fertilizers, and this will be done on experimental basis, or you can say as a pilot project, in 16 select districts. And there are two advantages of this. One is, directly the subsidy can be given based on web-based online integrated fertilizer monitoring system. Then second point, that means what I mean to convey with the first point is, the subsidy will go to the intended beneficiaries. That is one part. And the second part is, it will reduce diversion and smuggling of fertilizers to a large extent. So these two are the advantages of the proposed system of direct benefit transfer for fertilizer subsidy. Right, friends? Next one is Cho Ramaswamy, political commentator, then known for his magazine Tughlaq, died at the age of 82. And what is the original name of Cho Ramaswamy? The original name is Srinivasa Iyer Ramaswamy, right? So Tughlaq magazine in Tamil is famous for its wit and wisdom. Look into the next one. O Panneerselvam was sworn in as the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. He is from Periyakulam in Tamil Nadu. And this is for the third time he took charge as the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, because he worked as Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu during 2 tenures previously, when Jayalalitha had to resign because of some court cases. Right? And look into the next one. This is with regard to the Stanpan Suraksha app. This was launched by the Union Tribal Affairs Minister. That is the one part. So what is the purpose of this Suraksha app? This purpose basically to check inappropriate baby food promotion. To check the inappropriate baby food promotion, because breastfeeding is best for the children, and in our country, unfortunately, less than 50% are being breastfed during the first hour of birth. And nowadays, more and more babies are being born in hospitals or with the care of approved medical person. And under these circumstances, it is very much essential to promote the breastfeeding concept. And please don't forget, sometime back, central government launched Mother's Absolute Affection program. What is the purpose of Mother's Absolute Affection? This is basically to promote breastfeeding, and Madhuri Dixit is the brand ambassador for this MA program. We learned sometime back, please don't forget. Then IAAF, World Body, that is Athletics Federation, recently announced World Athlete for the Year Awards. Both male category and female category. In male category, Usain Bolt of Jamaica, he got it for the 6th time. So he became the World Athlete for the 6th time, and he belongs to Jamaica. And all of you are familiar with the feat attained by Usain Bolt. He won 100 meters, 200 meters, 4 by 100 meters, 3 gold medals each in 3 consecutive Olympics. 2008 Beijing, 2012 London, 2016 Rio de Janeiro. So he won consecutively, and he belongs to Jamaica, and he got the award for the 6th time. And if you look at women category, the lady who got this award is Almaz Ayana. Almaz Ayana belongs to Ethiopia. And what is her feat? She broke the world record in 10,000 meters in Olympics. So, World Athlete of the Year awards have gone to Usain Bolt of Jamaica and Almaz Ayana of Ethiopia. These two things, please don't forget. And Ravichandran Ashwin, who was declared as Cricketer of the Year by ICC. Then India and Qatar have signed 5 agreements. And when you are looking at Qatar, one important point, please don't forget. Qatar accounts for our 66% of total imports as far as liquefied natural gas or LNG is concerned. So, largest imports comes from Qatar if you look at liquefied natural gas. And look into the next one, Team Indus. This is a private moon mission. If someone talks about the Team Indus, this is a private moon mission. And it is going to be launched in the year 2017. And if someone talks about Team Indus, it is India's first private moon mission. So, PSLV will launch Team Indus private moon mission, right? And if you look at the next one, United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO, recently inscribed yoga. This is very important. UNESCO recently inscribed yoga as in its representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity. And this intangible heritage elements help demonstrate diversity of cultural heritage. This is very important. So, in the list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity, yoga was included. Intangible means it cannot be physically seen. The benefits are evident in human beings, and tangible is different, intangible is different. Tangible means something physically you can see. Intangible means they cannot be measured, they cannot be seen. So, yoga is included by UNESCO. Look into the next one. Incitral. What is Incitral? Incitral is United Nations Commission on International Trade Law. It specializes in reforms in commercial law worldwide, and during the past 50 years, it was established in the year 1966 and it completed Golden Jubilee. So, India hosted the Golden Jubilee celebrations of Incitral in New Delhi. And if you look at Rakesh Asthana, it created a lot of controversy. Rakesh Asthana became the interim director of CBI. This is Central Bureau of Investigation. And he succeeded Anil Kumar Sinha. Now, what is the procedure of selection of chief of CBI? The procedure is, it is to be selected by the collegium consisting of the Prime Minister, leader of opposition or the leader of largest party in opposition and Chief Justice of India. This is very important. Look into the next one. Kids Rights Foundation. This has got one important prize. The name of the prize is International Children's Peace Prize. Why this is awarded? This is awarded annually for a child anywhere in the world for his or her dedication to children's rights. And Kehkashan is based in UAE, and Kehkashan Basu got this award. And this award was given by Nobel Peace Laureate Muhammad Yunus. Look into the next one. Praveen Mahajan became the first woman president of All India Tennis Federation. So, for the first time, All India Tennis Federation has got woman president. The name is Praveen Mahajan and the outgoing president is Anil Khanna. Please don't forget. Then we are talking about a POSCO e-box. POSCO, all of you are familiar with POSCO. POSCO Act was brought in 2012 and POSCO means protection of children from sexual offenses. And in the parliament, it was mentioned that POSCO e-box was launched for easy and confidential registration of complaints regarding sexual offences against children. This was stated in the winter session of Parliament recently. Then Pankaj Advani, he won World's Billiards Championship for the 11th time. Please don't forget, for the 11th time, he got the World Billiards Championship, and the final was at Bengaluru. He defeated Peter Gilchrist of Singapore. Please don't forget. Government is contemplating to allow interoperability of bank-backed mobile wallets. And towards digital, I would like to tell you 2-3 important points. Whatever I have given in this PPT, left side, government is trying to promote various transactions based on NFC. What is NFC? NFC is near field communication, just tap and go. You need not swipe the card. Then biometric enabled smartphones. So smartphones should enable biometrics also. That means that with the help of fingerprints, people should be in a position to enable digital transactions. Then third one is USSD enabled mobile banking services, unstructured supplementary service data that is basically intended for feature phones. So government is giving more thrust for these three types. Then the middle one, whatever I have written, there are three types of mobile wallets. One is given by telecom players like Airtel, Jio Money. The second type is given by banks. And the third type is given by players like Paytm. So there are three types of mobile wallets. And right side, please go through them. This digital transactions failures can take place in three ways. Digital transactions failures can take place in three ways. Government is looking at all these things. That's why I listed out all these points here. How the failures can take place? Basically, failure can be at the level of telecom network. Maybe Airtel, maybe Idea, maybe BSNL. So, telecom network level, there can be failure. And second, there can be failure at the switch level. This payment gateways or this payment platforms like Visa, MasterCard, RuPay. So these are all payment platforms. So the failure can take place at this switch level. And the third one is at the back end of the servers of the banks. So three ways failures can take place when people are resorting to digital transactions. This is very important. Then last week we discussed about Lucky Grahak Yojana and Digi Dhan Vyapar Yojana. Lucky Grahak Yojana, 15,000 lucky customers every day for 100 days, and each lucky customer will get rupees 1000 each, and 3 mega prizes, and the largest mega prize is 1 crore. The draws will be on 14th April. And similarly, Digi Dhan Vyapar Yojana, this is meant for the merchants. And there are some restrictions here. Payments should be between rupees 50 to rupees 3000. Second one is only payments made through RuPay cards, UPI, then USSD and AEPS will be eligible. Payments made through Visa, MasterCard, Maestro are not eligible. And at the same time, e-wallets like Paytm, FreeCharge, etc., they are also not eligible. Look at the next one. With a view to ease digital payments, the central government is working on Android-based Aadhaar-enabled payment system application, and this is being developed in collaboration with the TCS. Right? So, government in future is promoting more with Aadhaar-enabled payment systems with fingerprints. And the last one, RBI recently allowed eKYC with the use of one-time password. So, eKYC process, that means an account can be opened with eKYC and one-time password, but there are some restrictions. One is, the limitation is deposit accounts. The maximum deposit in a year cannot exceed rupees 1 lakh, and at the same time, term loan accounts cannot exceed rupees 60,000. So if the total amount does not exceed this, that means the accounts opened through eKYC cannot accept beyond this limit. Right? So let us conclude the news at a glance. Have a nice day. Thank you.